Ari, guys, I've had loads of requests to do another media video, so I've decided to do another one, and I'm going to go over institutions as well as a bit of representations and audiences. These aren't the sort of areas that I can, you know, make a fun video out of. They're literally the most boring areas, so I'm just going to run through them and try and explain them sort of the best way that I can. So we'll start off with institutions. So institutions are literally just the companies that produce whatever you're analysing. And with institutions, you're basically just looking at how the company who has produced it have influenced the outcome of it. For me, it would really depend on what question I was answering, but the main points to consider are brand values, ownership, control and regulation. So brand values are a list of things which a company believes in. So for example, I like rock music, which is represented through my YouTube picture, and you can often find my videos being biased towards that sort of music or containing a lot of it. The BBC, for example, has an honest sort of professional value, and they're like appealing to all audiences and they like to have a lot of diversity. So brand values are basically a massive part of media text, and they affect what you see. They also link to bias and can make text have a biased view. For example, if a news publishing company is based in an area of England where there's a lot of youth crime, their news reports on crime and youth will probably be biased towards people of our age, because they won't necessarily consider the good if they're surrounded by the bad and constantly influenced by it. For ownership and control, you need to look at who the company is owned by. Is it a subsidiary company? Does it have a parent company? If so, then the actions of the subsidiary company will probably be controlled by the parent company and heavily influenced. Like Disney will own loads and loads of smaller companies, and Disney is obviously going to have a massive effect on what they produce. And this can link with, obviously, globalization and hegemony, especially if you're analysing a very well-known company. And globalization and hegemony basically just refer to the dominance of a particular brand. So it also tells you that the product that you're looking at will reach a large amount of people and is going to influence worldwide cultures, linking to cultural imperialism. Now, on the other hand, if it isn't a big company that's going to affect, you know, global audiences, if it's a private company, then it might have a lot more control over its products, and it may have quite a sort of narrow view on something. And also another factor that comes into it is, does the company that you're analysing, have you got any way of knowing if it relies on advertising and commercial success, or is it a publicly paid, is it publicly paid, like, you know, the BBC? With regulation, which is the next part of institutions, I'd be looking at what age rating the text is. If it doesn't display one, just kind of look at what you think it would be. You know, is it family friendly? Does it censor any swear words? Also look at how the audience can view the text. Are they online? Are they only available by print? And also, how would this influence an audience if a product was online as well as print? For example, if a company has a strong online presence as well, then it means that more audiences can view their content, and they can view it at any point, which will obviously widen their audience. So as I said before, and that probably wasn't easy to understand, but you're basically just analysing all of that and how that influences the product that you're viewing. So moving on to audience, if you want to see some audience theories, there's a lot included in my media theory revision video, which I'll put a link on the screen now if you want to watch that. Also, you could check out channels like Gabbit Media, or Media Gabbit, whichever one. I'll put a link in the description for that as well. Now, with audiences, you need to look, first of all, at what the audience is. Second of all, you need to understand why they view the text. So this is where the theory comes in. For example, we can apply the uses and gratifications to this video, because an audience could gain information out of it. Then to access top marks in an exam, you need to look at the effects that a product has on the audience, not just why they view it, but then the effects that it has as well, and also like how they might be consuming it. So for example, if you're actively consuming this video, then you would judge what I'm saying. So if I said something like, I don't know, media studies is the most popular A-level course, would you passively believe what could be the wrong answer, or would you actively go and look it up and check online to see whether I was actually giving you the right answer? So this is the same way that if young kids passively consume violent video games, they might start play fights with their friends and ended up causing damage and getting into trouble. So you've got to look at those aspects of a media text, how it may affect the audience, and also link into current issues that are going on in the media, moral panics and all that sort of stuff. And then finally I'm going to cover representation. So representation is just how people or objects are presented to the audience to give off a certain assumption. Again, I've talked quite a bit about this in my media theory video. I've mentioned theories like Medhurst's shorthand. But usually representation is actually quite easy to talk about, and this is because when you look at a text, you're always going to make assumptions based on what you see. So really, in most cases, all you need to do is actually write down what you see in a way that explains an audience as a whole. For example, if you see a character in an action movie wearing a red top, it could connote that they are an antagonist, or it could connote that they're angry and violent, as red, you know, has connotations of violence and anger. So a key term to do with representation is semiotics, and this refers to denotations and connotations. Denotations are the literal meaning for something, and the connotations are something which can be implied. For example, a flag denotes a country, but if you saw someone with a flag, it could connote pride and loyalty for that country. So that's about it. Hope that helped in a way, because I honestly didn't really know how to explain this in the best way, because I can't really do a funny video or something describing brand values. But yeah, if you did like the video, then don't forget to like it and subscribe and share and all that good stuff. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.